please stand for our playing of the national anthem? Is a descriptive, almost ballet-like work by composer James Swearingen. The graphic depiction of the new day's events gives this dynamic piece an additional dimension. Please enjoy Dawn of a New Day. Samuel Hazo is a composer who works primarily with the symphonic band vernacular. A number of his compositions have been commissioned and performed for large-scale public events, such as the London Summer Olympic Games in 2012. Southern Hymn is reminiscent of old traditional American folk spirituals, such as Shenandoah and Amazing Grace. The melody that is stated by a solo trumpet at the piece's opening is passed throughout the band as the support from the ensemble intensifies and relaxes the music. Here is Southern Hymn.
Thank you.
This next piece is a light lyrical composition that captures youth and innocence through the eyes of a child. Playful melodic lines will take you back to that simple time of your own childhood. Here is Rosanna Belante's A Childhood Remembered. This next selection is Pure Americana. In almost Colton-like fashion, Carl Strawman offers this original work that beautifully relays the majesty and beauty of America's heartland. A lively hoedown section complements the slower sections and energizes the piece. Sweeping melodies and spirited rhythms perfectly depict the prairie life of the Dakotas. This is Prairie Song. Thank you. Frank Ticelli wanted his setting of Amazing Grace to reflect the powerful simplicity of the words and melody, to be sincere, to be direct, to be honest. Ticelli believes that music has the power to take us to a place that words alone cannot. His own feelings about Amazing Grace reside in the setting itself. The harmony, texture, orchestration, and form are inseparable. Amazing Grace was written by John Newton, a slave ship captain who, after years of transporting slaves across the Atlantic Ocean to the New World, suddenly saw through divine grace the evilness of his acts. Here is Frank Ticelli's arrangement of Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
The Invercargill March was written by Alex Lithgow and named after his hometown on the South Island of New Zealand. The Invercargill raids alongside John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes Forever and Kenneth Alford's Colonel Bogey as one of the most popular marches in the world. It is especially popular in the United States, being a top favorite of the U.S. Marines, and was a regimental march of the 56th Infantry Regiment of the New York Guard during World War II. This is Alec Lithgow's Invercargill. Philip Sousa wrote this fun, tongue-in-cheek ditty as an encore for the Sousa Band. This simple eight-bar melody is played by a slew of soloists, giving this little tune tons of charisma. It's short, sweet, and tremendously entertaining. On behalf of the Hamilton County Community Band, I would like to thank you for joining us this evening. Please be well, be safe, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. For their final selection this evening, here is the Hamilton County Community Band.
Thank you. This has been a presentation of the Hamilton County Community Band and their Fall 2020 concert. Thank you for tuning in.